How's it going, everyone? It is Skullzy here with the latest and the greatest gaming news. Today I want to talk about the discovery that I made that seems to indicate that we are finally getting a highly anticipated sequel to a much beloved franchise. And although we haven't had a new entry into this franchise for a long time, it still maintains a pretty solid cult following. This game is almost certainly going to be a next-gen title for the PS5 and the Xbox Series X, and in case you can't tell by the title of this video, it is going to be a new skate game. After the fall of Tony Hawk's Pro Skater, Skate kind of took the mantle as the best skateboarding game out there, taking a different approach to skateboarding games with a more realistic feel and control system, which worked very, very well. And whenever you landed even what would otherwise be a simple trick in Tony Hawk's Pro Skater, doing this trick in Skate made it feel like an accomplishment. And it had a pretty good online mode as well, where the skills of the best players could really shine. Years and years ago, I used to actually skateboard, so even being an ex-skateboarder myself, I thought Skate was a very, very good interpretation in the video game world of skateboarding, and I am very, very hyped for a new entry into this franchise. We're going to break down my discovery together, as always, because I'm going to be recording my screen. That way you can see that my bullshit capacity meter is always running at 0%, and that way you can have the links and stuff to verify this information for yourself if you choose to. And we're going to start our adventure right here at the pending and active list of all of the trademarks and patents for Electronic Arts. Skate is published by EA, unfortunately. Hopefully this new Skate game isn't going to be full of microtransaction hell, but if we scroll all the way down, so much going down, we get to 26 and 27, which are two Skate trademarks filed for both Canada and Europe. Now, there is a Skate trademark for the United States as well. However, these two trademarks are already registered and just get updated, but there is something interesting regarding these things as well, but I'll get into that here in a few minutes. You can see that the two new Skate trademarks for both Europe and Canada are pending, meaning they are new trademarks representing some type of new product. And no, there doesn't need to be a new trademark filed for the United States as well, because they already have an existing and long-running trademark for the United States Patent and Trademark Office for Skate that you can see was filed as far back as 2009. These trademarks were filed on March 11th, 2020, and are still pending. If we look at the trademark documents, you can see right here that the application is published, meaning that this is a very, very early process in this trademark, and we might not see this new Skate game for another couple of years. Other than that, there isn't any solid information we can get other than Electronic Arts is currently working on some sort of Skate project, because they are filing trademarks related to this game. They are spending the money to pay the lawyers that go out and do this and start the entire trademark process internationally in various international trademark classifications for this new Skate game. It is also likely that instead of a new entry into the Skate franchise, this could be some sort of remaster of previous Skate games as well, but we can't tell one way or another from these trademarks. All we know is that EA is definitely working on something related to the Skate franchise. It's either a new Skate game or it's a remaster of previous Skate games. And like I said earlier, there was something interesting going on over the last few years regarding the United States Patent and Trademark Office classification for the Skate franchise. Electronic Arts was actually in danger of losing the rights to the Skate name, because for some reason, after all these years of this game franchise existing and selling numerous copies, the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office decided that the name Skate is kind of a very lucid name, and having the name Skate trademarked could potentially take away from the potential for other companies to make skating-related products, because any future companies may not be able to have anything related to the name Skate in their product name if Electronic Arts owns this Skate trademark. I did previous videos on this trademark battle, and it turns out that Electronic Arts must have won, because they are continuously renewing the Skate trademark now. If we look at the documentation for the United States Patent and Trademark Office Skate trademark filing, you can see that the most recent events to take place regarding this trademark have to do with the trademark actually being renewed. And an interesting thing about this renewal is, in order to prove to the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office that they are indeed planning to keep using this trademark, they somehow provided evidence proving that they have an active statement of use regarding Skate. The USPTO accepted their statement of use, and this renewal in itself and the type of renewal that this is another small piece of evidence that another Skate game is definitely on its way. So unfortunately, although we can't get like any gameplay information or information as to whether or not this is a remaster of a previous Skate game or indeed a new entry into the Skate franchise, what I can say with 100% confirmation is that something related to Skate is definitely being worked on right now over at Electronic Arts. And judging by the timing of these trademark filings, this game will almost certainly be a next-gen title for the PS5 and the Xbox Xbox Series X. And seeing how it's been quite a long time since we've had any skateboarding games, I'm kind of curious to see how well this game will be received. Is there still an audience for these types of games? If they do make another skate game, do you plan on getting it? I probably will get it just to try it out, just for the nostalgic purposes, and see if I can still get into these types of games. I know I had a lot of fun with the previous skate games, but like I said, it's been a long time since I've played one of these games, and it's probably the same kind of situation for other people out there. As always, what I want to know is, what do you have to say about all of this? Are you hyped for another skate game? Do you want it to be a new entry into the franchise, or a remaster of an old skate game? Let me know down in the comments below, and if your comment wins the internet, and it may get featured in a future video. If you like the content, be sure to give the video a thumbs up, and if you don't, give it a thumbs down. If you want to stay in the know when it comes to the latest and the greatest gaming news, be sure to subscribe and turn notifications on so you don't miss the latest uploads. Follow me over on Twitter for the latest channel updates. Check out the official Skullzy merchandise site over on Teespring. Come over to the channel Discord chat server, where there is always an awesome and active conversation and some speculation taking place. And if you want to have your hand in providing future content and getting access to unique and awesome awards, then consider subscribing to the community over on Patreon or joining the channel here on YouTube as an exclusive channel member. Links for all of these awesome things are down in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching. Be sure to tune in next time when you have to buy a microtransaction just for your character in Skate to have legs.
It just works.